Hello, everybody. How you doing? I've known Money Smart Guy for a very long time now. And in this episode, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. Before he was the Money Smart Guy, he was really the Money Dumb Guy. But you'll see in a minute, he's going to share with you his three financial horror stories that almost took him out. But before we get started, if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, okay? Let's get started here in this episode of the 7-Figure Squad, three financial horror stories that could have taken out the Money Smart Guy. Starting in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them teachers, now I'm making 7 figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas, and the publishing of this video. It is Halloween, so I appreciate you guys for celebrating my birthday with me by dressing up in all your costumes. That's correct. As of today, the shooting of this video in 2021, it is my birthday too as well. So yes, I am 48 years old as of today. So thank you so much for your birthday wishes, and thank you so much for watching this episode. If you haven't done so already, please hit that like button. And make sure you click subscribe to our YouTube channel. Our goal is to get to 150,000 subs, so therefore we can donate to a church, charity, or nonprofit $5,000 on behalf of the 7-Figure Squad YouTube community to bless that organization. So, that being said, I want to jump into my three horror stories. That's correct. It wasn't a treat for me. These were definitely tricks that, sadly, I went through in my life, and I hope they can help you avoid some of the mistakes I went through with my finances, with my relationships. So let's jump into number one. Number one, I filed chapter bankruptcy in 1996 in Orange County, California. And I made a big, big problem by trusting other people with my credit cards. I trusted other people with my credit cards. I trusted other people to have my best interests at heart. And I left on a deployment. And make a long story short, not only did I come back with $20,000 in credit card debt, which was equivalent to my yearly salary as a sergeant in the Marines, but also I let them use my car. So I let them use my car, and I had them pull it out of storage, and they used my car, and somewhere along the way, somebody stole my radio. And I looked into this, like, really, do I really have friends? Are these the people I can really trust? Because it didn't look like somebody stole my radio. It really looked like somebody methodically, systematically, neatly took apart my dashboard, took out my head unit, took out my stereo system and sold it secondhand, and gave me the sob story that they borrowed my car and somebody broke into my car and stole my radio. I didn't buy it. But anyway, make a long story short, I knew right then and there not to trust anybody else with my credit cards or my car, and thinking they have my best interests at heart. Those are some of the young, stupid things I did in my early 20s in trusting people with things that I thought was valuable to me. And here's the thing too as well. Because it's valuable to you doesn't mean that somebody else thinks it's valuable to them. So don't presume that somebody has your values and principles and raised with thinking about money the same way you did. Sadly, a lot of people out there are just looking out for themselves. And I learned the hard way to not trust people with my stuff. All right, number two. This is a big one. There's a reason why relationships and money are such huge topics online, whether it be video, audio, or blog posts, because it's a very, very touchy subject. But I ended up marrying the wrong person. I ended up marrying the person that I met in a club. Okay, dog me out. Okay, here's your time right now to put it in the comment section. Ha, 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 whatever it came to be. Money Smart Guy, I told you. My alter ego there told me I was a money dumb guy at one point. That's correct, because I not only met somebody in a club, but married. The only good thing that came out of that was my son, who's now 26 years old. But think about this, and all in 1 year, got married, went through financial hell, divorce, child separation, all that type of stuff, all craziness in the early years of my son's life. And you would think that, well, they're too young, they'll never remember. Well, those kids do remember. My son's 26 years old today, oddly enough, still remembers those moments. And on top of that, not only did I marry somebody, you end up having sex with somebody, and next thing you know, oops, pregnant. So I'm being as transparent, open, and authentic with you as possible to help you learn from my mistakes. Because think about this. If you're having sex with somebody, I hope you tell yourself, I am willing to live with this person for the rest of my life. Their issues, their problems, their drama, their parents, their family, their friends, if I'm going to have sex with this person, that's what you're saying you're going to accept. Because Lord forbid, you wake up one day and you get this weird voicemail or this weird text message say, we need to talk. Or you get this picture that the pregnancy test is positive and they're pregnant. Guess what you got to do for the rest of your life? You got to deal with this person for the rest of your life. I didn't say you had to marry him. I didn't say you had to live together. I didn't say you have to raise a child together. You got to find some way, somehow, to co-parent at the worst case scenario and deal with this person for the rest of your life. And then you have a human being that's going to be reminding you of your bad decisions and reminding you that you need to change and that you need to improve, that you need to set a better example. The moments of you just having sex, all good. Knock yourself out if that's what you want to feel. But you have to deal with the consequences. You're free to make your own choice. You're free to make your own decisions, but you're not free of the consequences that result from making those type of choices. In my situation, having kids with the wrong person, I paid my entire 30s to repay back the mistakes in my 20s because I chose the wrong people to marry. I chose the wrong people to have sex with and have kids with. Very bad situation. And then you send up, instead of generational blessings and a generational inheritance, you potentially set up a generational curse, because then those children think and perceive what relationships will look like through the lens of experiencing it with you. So I've spent a large part of my adult life being a father to my daughters, my son, my three older kids, just to share with them all my mistakes, all my experiences of making the wrong decisions. And so thus far, my kids, they've turned out well. I have a constant communication with them at all times, but it's something that I always have in the back of my head when I'm talking to my kids, making sure they avoid my mistakes is something that we have to constantly evolve and communicate with. So if you're going to avoid a financial horror story yourself, make sure you pick the right relationships, because the wrong ones has major consequences. And consider this too as well. The legal system, it's turned against the guys. I remember going to court one time and I had custody of the kids. And for some reason, the judge automatically thought that the mother had custody of the kids. No, I had custody of the kids. He made a decision in court at one time. It flipped things around, caused us to be in court in another year and a half, cost me another $10,000, $20,000 in legal fees, caused me to have an attorney for the kids to represent them. It was just a mess, turmoil. I can't tell you, every time I go to court, it's never a place where things go right for a lot of people. You go to court, a lot of things are going against you. And if you want to save yourself some unnecessary emotional grief, financial grief, spiritual grief, unnecessary wasted time, make sure that you marry your careful. So have a checklist. Have a checklist of the values and principles that you stand for. And our two younger ones, 11-year-old JoJo and 2.5-year-old Jordan, they're experiencing some of the best things that are a result of that, because Sheena and I are together. We're married. We're building a life together. We're raising our children together. The three older kids, I'm constantly having conversation with them, because that's something that they don't have, that sadly myself as a dad made a bad decision for them not to enjoy. But that doesn't mean that the rest of our lives we can't live the best version of that life. Avoid marrying the wrong person. Make sure that you have the same values and principles, that you guys are grounded and anchored on the same thing. So please, I implore you, subscribers of the 7-Figure Squad, avoid that financial horror story yourself. And last but not least, number three, speaking of relationships, because of my lack of understanding with the aspects of running my personal life, that spilled over into my business life. Think about this. How you do one thing is how you do everything. So if you're poor in your judgment in your personal relationships, guess what happens to your business relationship and choosing them too as well? It's also very poor. It's very haphazard too as well. So I chose to pick the wrong marketing partner to brand myself. I think it was mid, late 2000s, to go on a radio show in Chicago. He's running a real estate show. And I was doing the financial segments of the show. And to make a long story short, he's soliciting investors during the radio show to invest in real estate. And I was on the radio show soliciting investors to make sure that they buy into financial education. Everybody on that radio show found out they got a lawsuit, because these guys, the guys that were sponsors of the show, were actually taking investors' money and not actually investing in real estate. And everybody on that show, they thought they were complicit in this guy's dealings. And I spent $25,000. This thing could have taken out my entire career. But also, I got an investigation with the Illinois Securities Department to find out whether or not I was involved in these dealings, which they found out that I was not. I just had to disclose that I'm not a financial advisor. I had to disclose that I'm not an investment advisor, et cetera, et cetera. But that lack of making a good decision, I played with fire by choosing the wrong business partners to market and brand with. That's why today I'm very specific why I bring it to my circle. And that was a financial horror story for me that took me about 2 years of just grief, 2 years of just dealing with having to talk to clients and having to address this financial scenario that had nothing to do with it. Matter of fact, I was subpoenaed all my bank records and I showed them I have taken zero money from these guys. So if you want to avoid a financial horror story from taking you out, please consider who you market and brand with and who you decide to co-sponsor and represent their product or their service, because it might just be not the treat you want in your life, but the trick that takes you out financially. So before I let you guys go, please check out these two videos here. My reaction to financial horror stories on Reddit, also some financial TikToks, because there's some people out there that's got some questionable TikToks on them being financial gurus and giving people financial guidance to help them in their life. So please check out my reaction to these two videos. That being said, guys, if you haven't done so already, please click like and follow our business page on Facebook, Money Smart Guy. If you've done so already, please subscribe to our YouTube channel here and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. From Dallas, Texas, I'm your Money Smart Guy. And until we meet again, continue to live smart. Continue to love smart and be mighty smart today. God bless you guys. Bye-bye. Trick or treat, everybody. Happy Halloween from the Money Smart Daddy.